What's going on, guys? Frosty talking back again with my WWE Royal Rumble 1993 review. And this was a decent Rumble. I wouldn't say it was a bad Rumble. So we start off the Royal Rumble 1993 with a tag team match, like we do in all kind of these earlier Royal Rumbles. We have the Steiners versus the Beverly Brothers, and this was a good match. I thought that this was a good way to open up Rumble 93. It got the crowd hot. They was really hot for this match. Obviously the Beverly Brothers, they was double teaming on Rick Steiner, and he was getting all the face reaction and stuff like that. He was getting all the face pops and stuff like that. I thought both teams did their jobs well. Obviously Beverly Brothers as the heels and the Steiners as the faces. Steiners go over with the win. And then we have, we're supposed to have an Intercontinental title match with Shawn Michaels and Marty Jannetty. Now, obviously, if you guys remember, they had the barbershop window segment, the famous barbershop segment window, I think a few weeks before this. And then they had a Shawn Michaels had an IC title match on Raw. Eddie, and he would challenge somebody in the crowd. He was obviously Marty Jannetty. And this would lead to this match here. So Marty Jannetty, Shawn Michaels. I could be off with how things went with the whole title match. What I know from Shawn Michaels' book, whatever, and stuff like that. I think I'm right. But anyway, this match doesn't even get started. We didn't think it was going to get even started because Shawn Michaels is in the ring with Sherry, and Marty Jannetty has the mirror, and he's going to hit it over Shawn Michaels, and then Sherry ducks out of the way and takes a bump for him. Then we get the actual match. Sherry comes back and she's okay like 2 minutes later. Like, I don't get why. Like, why couldn't she just sell it a bit more? But we have Michaels and Jannetty. This was a solid match, obviously, and you could see that Shawn Michaels at this point was coming to his own. He was coming to his own persona with the Heartbreak Kid and stuff. And it was a good match. You had Sherry use a heel on Marty Jannetty, and Shawn Michaels hit the situation with a win, and it was a good match. Then we had Razor Ramon versus Bret Hart in a singles match. This was a solid match. This was Razor Ramon's first Royal Rumble, as Razor Ramon, obviously, because he came in 1992. Then we had the Royal Rumble match. So Ric Flair and Bob Backlund start off first. The first thing that Jesse Buddy Ventura says that is how great it would be for Bob Backlund to win the Royal Rumble at 42 years old. And him and Flair start off the Rumble. We have Yokozuna's in there. We have the Macho Man Randy Savage. We have a couple of the guys in there. Ted DiBiase was in there. Then we get to the Owen Hart was in there. And obviously, we get to the final three, which is Owen Hart, Yokozuna, the Macho Man Randy Savage, and Bob Backlund. It's like four. So Backlund eliminates Owen, eliminates Backlund, and then Owen gets eliminated by Macho Man, and then it's Savage and Yokozuna. Yokozuna came in at number 27, and this was a good ending. Yokozuna just throws him outside the ring and gets the win, and that's how the Rumble ended. So yeah, that's what you